Of all the most bizarre points of research in science, the growing theory of parallel universes is perhaps one of the most exciting. The idea that our universe, the largest structure we know of, could potentially be one of many can feel at times almost impossible to comprehend. But scientists are increasingly inclined to take the topic seriously, with one physicist even theorizing different levels of multiverse in our wider reality. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if humanity lives in a level 4 multiverse? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Physicist Max Tegmark not only believes in the multiverse, but has proposed his own multi-layered structure for it. He argues that the concept of the multiverse shouldn't be considered a theory only, but rather a prediction based on other more established theories such as cosmic inflation. In whichever way he arrives to the conclusion though, Tegmark separates his multiverse into four different levels, each building upon the other in terms of complexity and possibility. A level 1 multiverse for Tegmark is the most basic. It assumes that the universe is both infinite and has a somewhat even distribution of particles, which are both well-supported claims. From here, it then figures that the universe goes on forever, repeating any and every particle arrangement allowed by the laws of nature, theoretically an infinite number of times over. In Tegmark's Level 2 multiverse, universes have the potential to isolate themselves across another even higher plane, which allows for infinite bubble universes that each contain Level 1 multiverses within them. As the structure of reality broadens, Tegmark suggests that these bubble universes could then have different particle possibilities, elements, and perhaps dimensions. Next, Level 3 incorporates quantum mechanics into the equation and theorizes that each time a decision is made, any decision, or something random occurs, the by now already multi-layered universe splits into different branches once again. A Level 3 multiverse doesn't allow for more physical possibilities in and of itself, but each decision, even if it's a tiny decision, does get its own version of the universe from that point forwards, and all splinter universes from every possible moment are equally real. We've taken a closer look at the lower levels of Tegmark's model in other videos on our channel, so be sure to check them out. But now, our focus is on 4. A level 4 multiverse is even more fundamentally based on one of the greatest questions in science. What is reality? For Tegmark, there are two main schools of thought. The Aristotelian paradigm says that physical reality, and what we experience of it as humans, is real, but we use mathematics to try and make sense of it. While the Platonic paradigm takes the opposite stance and sees mathematics as the real truth of the universe, while our perceptions of it are only limited approximations. More broadly speaking, Tegmark shows how this question of reality has important implications for general science. For example, if the Aristotelian view is the right one, then scientists will never find a theory of everything, since our subjective experiences are all different. If the Platonic view is right, however, if mathematics makes up the universe itself, then there is a theory of everything out there somewhere. With regard to Tegmark's multiverse specifically, Level 4 sides with the Platonic view, that mathematics is key. The proposal first draws upon our overriding innate reliance on math in just this universe. Mathematical laws seem fundamental to us. For instance, when humanity launched Voyagers 1 and 2 in the 1970s, we equipped them with a golden record inscribed with various attempts to communicate with potential aliens through science and math. Our cosmic position given pulsar locations, what our hydrogen atoms look like, and various instructions coded in binary. They were all etched into the now far-off golden disks. The thinking being that math should transcend any possible language or communication barrier between us and whoever should find the Voyagers. The thinking also being that the universe is, in essence, made of math. But Tegmark takes the notion further for a level 4 multiverse, by drawing on ideas such as Robert Nozick's fecundity assumption, which suggests that if a world is possible, then it must exist. Level 4 supposes, then, that all possible mathematical equations, and therefore worlds, must take place somewhere. Even with the infinite bubbles and endless splinters of the multiverse as per levels 1, 2, and 3, there must also exist more than just the mathematical world of this universe or this multiverse to contend with. This creates an essentially infinite degree of versatility and an infinite number of possibilities. Levels 1 to 3 already allow a huge amount of diversity in terms of dimensions and possible elements, yes, but all must still conform to certain natural expectations. Time, motion, thermodynamics, and more must be adhered to. However, this isn't the case at level 4. as any one multiverse can ultimately have totally different laws of nature compared to any other multiverse. With only the endless possibility of math to guide it, there's really no telling how reality could unfold in any one place. This creates worlds that are very hard to imagine. There could be universes where time moves backwards, or in irregular spurts instead of along a dependable line. There might be places where gravity exerts itself in a wholly different way, or where thermodynamics works differently as well. Universes where motion works differently, for example, could have moving objects that naturally get faster as time moves on instead of slower. Or perhaps there'd be a place where there were only two speeds, zero and the speed of light, which can now be anything too and not just the speed of light as we understand it. These worlds are of course so difficult to imagine because we're so used to the reality we just so happen to live in, where objects fall to the ground and light travels at a consistent speed. But when those laws can vary, anything is possible. Beyond just what's inside them, however, every universe in a level 4 multiverse is also a mathematical shape. Thinking about just our universe, that means that somewhere, at some higher level of understanding, even it could be described as a specific shape by mathematicians. But now every other possible shape should also correspond to a universe too. And herein lies the basic endless landscape for a level 4 multiverse. Every mathematical shape imaginable has an accompanying reality. These aren't optional either. Tegmark suggests that if a shape is mathematically possible, then it must have a real physical incarnation. He calls this principle mathematical democracy, highlighting that the multiverse isn't simply allowed to pick and choose which shapes to represent, and so it must represent all possibilities. There is no cosmic favoritism or asymmetry in a level 4 multiverse. One final realization out of all of this, however, is that level 4 would mean once and for all that our universe isn't special. Instead, it's just a mathematical shape in and amongst endless other mathematical shapes. It's just a ball of complicated equations in a never-ending mass of other balls made up of other complicated equations. A level 4 multiverse is then the last and definitely final level of Tegmark's multiverse model, as it could never be superseded. Because if we were to devise some other structure to contain all possible multiverses to this point, then really we'd have only devised another mathematical shape, another mathematical reality. And so it would simply be a continuation of level 4. So what might the future hold for us? Will the multiverse ever be officially proven and confirmed? Or will it remain a subject for increasingly confident scientists to debate only? Across his various articles, papers, and presentations, Max Tegmark appears to concede that level 1 to his model remains the easiest to come to terms with and therefore the least controversial. But as we move up through the levels, this bold attempt to explain reality gets more and more exciting. At the very top of Tegmark's thinking, even whole universes become really quite tiny things. We've moved from one infinite expanse to infinite bubbles containing expanses, to the many worlds of the quantum realm, to the mathematical structures that could encase them all. It's been quite a journey, but that's what it could be like if humanity lived in a level 4 multiverse. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.